the remix.
Same old, just a different day. I kept trying to get it each and every way. Wait,
hey guys, what's going on? What's going on, everybody? What's going on?
What's up, you guys?
Y'all are probably thinking that was a horrible intro.
Was it really?
It probably was.
I don't think it was that bad.
But you know what? This is our first YouTube video. Man, so look, there's going to be a lot of stuff that we're going to get wrong.
Yes. Right?
Like the lighting, like the scene.
Don't do us now.
I mean.
This is a good scene.
We're in our car.
Yes.
And let me tell you guys.
I don't know if that's fortunate or unfortunate, but we're in the car.
Probably both, right? We have been putting off doing a video. So look, we've talked about doing a YouTube channel forever, right?
For a long time.
For a long time. I mean, and maybe I'm biased when I make this comment, but I think I have an amazing family, right? We're very talented, funny, you know what I'm saying? And I just think we have so much to offer, but we've been putting off doing this channel for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Just waiting for the perfect moment.
Perfect moment.
Waiting to have all of the right equipment, the best lighting, you know.
You know, dark skin, you need some light. Maybe need a little bit more. A little bit more.
Really? You know what I'm saying? Just wanting to have everything, you know, perfect. Because, you know, in my mind, you know, these videos are a reflection of, you know, the people that are in them, I guess, right? So I just decided, you know, to stop waiting. My wife has been like, hey, let's do the video. And I look around and I'd be like, oh, you know, it's a mess right now, or the light's bad, or I don't have the cool microphone and the little thing that, you know. And I was just like, you know what, man, let's just shoot the doggone video.
Just do right? it.
So.
And do it. And do it.
That was take one, right? Mm-hmm. This is going to be take two. That probably won't know better than the first. Anyway, look, my name is Tremaine MacTiller, a.k.a. Mr. M5.
And I am Felicia MacTiller. That's Felicia, not Felicia. Felicia MacTiller, a.k.a. Mrs. M5.
Give me some. Hey, and we're coming to you guys from the great state of Mississippi.
Woo!
Yes, guys, there's paved roads here. I lived in Miami for a number of years, and people would always ask me where I'm from. And they'd be like,
Mississippi.
You guys still have dirt roads? No! There's no dirt. I'm sure there are dirt roads
there
somewhere
are dirt
here.
Roads
I mean, we,
here. Wait,
but
no,
the ones that we travel are paved.
Yes, they are.
You know, now depending on where you at, you know, it can be a bit, you know, turbulent on the street, but the roads we're on paved. Anyway, guys, we want to welcome you all to our YouTube channel, M5, The Family Hustle.
Wow.
Right? This is our first video.
Yes.
Right? Season 1, Episode 1.
Okay, let's go with it.
Let's go with it, right?
Let's go
Season
with it.
One, episode one. Yep, mm-hmm. Absolutely, man. Why is it so important for you to do this channel? Like, why, you know, why M5 The Family Hustle?
I think that we just have a lot of different dynamics in our family.
Definitely have a lot of that.
You know, I think that our background, you know, your background, my background, is quite unique. We have a dynamic family, and you know, I think that other people can definitely relate to, you know, things that we go through. I think that, you know, everybody goes through things, but sometimes there's no outlet, or you feel like there's no outlet. But you know, I want to be able to reach other people and, you know, just kind of help people through our experiences, things that we've been through, things that we may be going through with, you know, family, business, personal, you know, relationship stuff. I just want to be able to help somebody else.
Wait a minute. Hold on, guys. Look, time out right quick. So, are we going to really, like, discuss, like, our family personal stuff on
here? Yes.
Really? Like, how much? Not all of it, right?
A lot of it.
I mean, like, you plan on being really transparent?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know if we're talking about that.
It doesn't matter.
Anyway, guys, look, man. Hey, it's going down, man. I'm talking about raw, unfiltered,
uncut. People need that.
Man, we're going to be talking about it.
Just like you were saying, you know, you wait for the perfect time, the perfect this, you know, but it's a reflection of who we are. We're not perfect people.
We're not.
You know, we're not perfect people. This is not a perfect world. And so I don't ever want to pretend to be something that I'm not.
I like that. All right. What does M5 mean, by the way?
M5 means motivated. It's an acronym. Motivated, financially independent, victorious entrepreneur.
Woo!
Did you catch that?
Boy, that's hot.
Did you catch that?
Did y'all hear that?
Did you catch
that? Can you say it again?
Run it back.
Man, that was hot.
Motivated, financially independent, victorious entrepreneurs.
Man, boy, I love that, man. Yeah. I feel that all in my soul right now, man.
I felt that.
All in my soul.
Yes.
Look, guys, and it don't mean that, you know, you're there yet. You know what I'm saying? It means that you're on your way.
It's a mindset.
You know what I'm saying? That right there is what it is, right? M5 is a movement.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So I want you guys to tune in, right, to our channel, M5 The Family Hustle, right? And we're going to, you heard her just say it, right? I mean, hey, we're going to be extremely transparent. We're going to discuss a lot of things as it relates to our family, life, business, you know, work, everything, right? And we have a blended family.
Yeah.
All right? We have a blended family for starters. I mean, hey, we have 3 kids. My wife is, you know, giving birth biologically to 1, mm-hmm. you know, but she's raised 3, right?
Yeah,
and, you know, they're here with us. I mean, that's going to be, you know, that's going to be a story. And you all get an opportunity to meet them.
Yes.
You know, they're young entrepreneurs as well, right?
Yes.
So a little bit about yourself, man. I mean, why should people tune in to listen to Mrs.
To listen
M5?
Mrs. M5, oh my God.
I can think of a lot of reasons, right?
So, Ms. M5 gonna help y'all get y'all whole life, right?
Whole life.
So, I'm gonna tell y'all, you know, just a little bit about me. Originally, I'm from Miami, Florida. You know, I am a 305 girl.
The bottom.
Hold up now.
Liberty City.
Wait a minute now.
She grew up right next door to the Poke and Beans.
Well,
you guys ever watch First 48 and the Poke and Beans?
But let me tell you something, right?
How many of those crimes get solved?
Let me tell you something, right? I may be from the hood, but I'm not of the hood. But I can be hood. You understand me? You hear me? Okay, just make sure you remember that, right? Mm. So, yeah, I did grow up right in Miami, right in the heart of Miami. Not the Miami that you guys see when y'all watching, you know, TV and movies and stuff. No, it's not the South Beach Miami. It's the Miami, Miami. But yeah, I've lived in Miami pretty much all my life until we moved here to Mississippi. Pretty great student. I think I'm very like studious. Like
definitely more than I am.
I like school. I like learning. Let me say that. I don't necessarily like school, but I like learning. At the very young age of 14 years old, I was diagnosed with osteosarcoma. And basically what that means is it's a bone cancer. So I started chemotherapy.
And I know some of you guys are probably thinking right now that that's the reason her hair is so short.
No, I just don't like no hair.
It's really not. Now maybe after she lost all her hair and, you know, she was undergoing treatment. Yeah, maybe she just got used to it.
I did.
Now, I think that some of the treatment probably did damage some hair follicles and stuff like that. But
I don't know. But I be looking at my daddy, too, y'all. And, like, he got them. They call them cowlicks.
Cowlicks.
Yeah, he got that, too.
That cow been licking your hair, too.
Golly. You know what? Anyways.
That cow been licking her head, boy.
But, yeah, I'm bald by choice. But if you really want to know why I'm bald, that's another story. Okay, I'm going to save that story. I'm going to tell y'all that story, but that's another day. Mm. But I was diagnosed with cancer, you know, 14 years old, chemotherapy, surgery. I went into remission, and then like 5 years later, the cancer had returned in my lung. So I had to do chemotherapy again. I had to do surgery again and all of that stuff. I was fine for maybe about 12 years or so. Met my wonderful husband. We got married. we had a baby, you know, brought that whole blended family together. And then in 2012, I was diagnosed with a totally unrelated sarcoma still, but it was a soft tissue sarcoma, and it was in my left hamstring. Weirdest place ever. But again, you know, chemotherapy, surgery, and I also had radiation that time. And then in 2014, they found a metastasis to my lung. So chemotherapy, surgery. So what's the recurring theme here? Tons and tons and tons of chemotherapy and also a lot of surgery. But here I am, you know, I'm 38 years old. I am super duper blessed, you know, because of all the medications and stuff, you know, the doctors honestly didn't know if I would ever be able to have a baby on my own.
Oh, that's a whole nother story.
Oh, so man. We'll talk about that as well. Mm. He's 10 now. Just know that he's 10.
Just got out the car a few minutes ago. We'll talk.
He's 10 and he's doing great. So, I just feel totally blessed.
As a matter of fact, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I'll forget if I don't tell you now. We got a phone call because, you know, he had the ultrasound the other day. So they called today.
They called you back?
They called me today. And his right kidney is totally free of, what was it?
Just because you asked me, Doc, I can't remember. He had hydronephrosis.
Yes, so there's no hydronephrosis in the right kidney.
In the right kidney.
Whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
The left kidney has gotten better, but there's still a little bit there.
Okay.
But they want to see him again in 6 months.
Awesome.
Right? So, look, man, we wanted to have a baby, okay?
That's another story. Let me finish my introduction. Okay. Here, write that down so we can come back to that.
I got to write that down. I won't forget.
So, anyways, my blessing, he's 10 years old now. And so, we are living here. We've been in Mississippi now for going on 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
This will be 5 years for Tremaine.
The Magnolia State.
It'll be four and a half years. Wait, don't miss this. 5 years that he's been here, 4.5 years that I've been here, and that's another story as well. Why is the time difference? Anyways, you know, I am blessed. I do believe that, you know, without a test, you do not have a testimony. So I feel like, you know, God has really placed me in a position to share my testimony. You know, recently someone, a young lady that's really, really close to me, was also diagnosed with the very same thing that I had at her age. So, you know, I think that I've been able to help the family out, you know, just kind of navigate and just kind of really give that hope that, you know, it's not just a death sentence, you know, mm-hmm. that cancer is not a death sentence anymore. But I'm here, you know, I'm alive. I feel good. I'm bald head by choice. Glad that I'm able to be self-employed.
Her choice.
My choice. Yes. Definitely thankful that I'm able to be self-employed so that I can take, you know, time that I need to heal and be with my family and stuff like that. What else?
You can't just stop and be like, what else?
I know, right? But you threw me off. I'm loving my life. God is blessing me. I mean, we're talking about my background, my biography. Time out.
Take two. What else? Like, how does that don't work?
I was flowing and then you messed me up though.
How?
You was talking.
Okay.
Okay, so anyways, I mean, it's just a blessing to be here. You was asking me why they should follow me, why they should listen to me.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Cause you forgot.
I'm that chick, you know? I don't know. Like, I just been through so much stuff. Like, I can just relate to a lot of stuff and, you know, I'm just me.
I got you. You guys are going to get a lot of that, by the way, tuning into this channel, a lot of realness.
Yeah.
Man, you're going to learn a lot. You know what I'm saying? You're going to laugh a lot. You know, you may cry some too. You know what I'm saying?
I'm proud of here.
You may cry a little bit, but you're definitely going to laugh.
Yeah.
And you're going to learn a lot, right?
Yeah.
You know, so we will focus on family. You know, just the challenges that we face, I'm sure challenges that a lot of you guys have faced,
mm-hmm.
you know, we're going to talk a lot about entrepreneurship. All right, guys. So look, a little bit about Mr. Ring 5 himself.
How we apologize for the interruption, right? Kid calling.
I mean, I told this guy, I said, look, we're about to shoot our first YouTube video. We're about to make a grand appearance, right?
And what he didn't know, write a message.
And then, anyway, so.
They sorry.
A little bit about me. Right here from the SIP, man, great state of Mississippi. Did I say that already? 601. And, man, just, you know, father of three, you know, happily married guy. Right here. And, look, man, I just want to have a lot of fun with this YouTube channel. Man, I want to have an impact on a lot of people. We're going to share a lot, you know what I'm saying? And I look forward to getting to know you guys. Look, any recommendations whatsoever for new YouTubers, please post them below. We're going to post links to our social media channels, right? You guys can follow me on Instagram at Mr. M5 all day. She can be followed at RVP underscore Mrs. M5 there on Instagram as well. We also have a Facebook fan page, M5, M-F-I-V-E, right? You can catch her on Wealthy Women Winning, right? Guys, look, this is going to be an amazing journey. I guarantee you these videos are going to evolve, right? And you guys are going to see, you know, the progression. We're not where we want to be yet, right? But we're getting there. And I want you guys to see it. I want you guys to be a part of it. You know what I'm saying? And I want us to get there together. You know what I'm saying? If you guys aren't where you want to be in life right now, look, it's absolutely okay. As long as you wake up tomorrow, you have an opportunity, you know what I'm saying, to get at it again. And I recommend you guys get at it every single day. Don't ever give up. Don't ever allow yourself to feel like, you know, you're too old. Because some people may say, I mean, you guys are too old to be trying to, you know, be, you know, YouTubers and stuff. I don't know, man. But look, I feel like, you know, we got a message and we just want to share it. We just want to share it with the world. So,
right.
Hey, guys, look, hit like. Up there, down there, look somewhere. Look, I see the people and they do it and it looks so cool.
We
gotta right?
figure it out though.
Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, share this video with your friends and their friends and their mamas and all them people. You know what I mean? And yeah, man. Catch us next time. These videos are gonna get better and better, I promise you guys.
See y'all later. Y'all right. Five family hustle.
Hustle.